Hi everyone, this is Lynn from Hypotenuse AI. Now I'll be showing you how to write high quality, researched articles of 1,000 words in less than 15 minutes. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use a blog article tool to write your article from start to finish, including title ideas, building outlines, researching content, and writing and polishing the article itself. I'll also share some tips on customizing the content to exactly how you want it. Let's get started. We'll start by generating some title idea. First of all, you need to describe your topic to the AI for it to understand how to structure your article. So for instance, we might want to start writing about how to care for an alopecia. In this case, I can be as detailed as saying a detailed guide on how to care for an alopecia, or I could switch it up to a listicle of 10 tips on how to care for an alopecia. If I want to, I can even be as specific as say, include these following points, and you can say step one, step two, or any specific tips that you want. So in this case, we'll go back to a broader and more generic one and just see what the AI comes up for. The next section is on primary keywords. And what this really means is the SEO keywords that you want to optimize the article for. Here, I would recommend just choosing one primary keyword, but you can add up to three different keywords that are mainly secondary to what your article is about. In this case, maybe the one that I have already researched is on sunlight requirements. And this is perhaps one of the topic clusters that I would like to talk about for caring about alopecia plants. Next up, in the tone section, you can select from conversational to enthusiastic, professional, or even describe your own tone. To describe your own tone, you can angle it towards a female person, or you can angle it towards your target audience, or you can be as specific as you like and describe your target audience. If you want to skip past generating titles and you already have one in mind, you can also just flip the switch and write your title here. So go ahead and generate some titles. Great, I can see six different title ideas that the AI has generated for me. Sun Smart, How to Care. So these are pretty good. If I wanted to, I can always go in and edit my title, maybe for brevity or to just make it a little bit more catchy. And once I'm done with this, I can go ahead and click next to start creating my outline. So in my outline section, here you can see that the AI has already come up with one outline that gives me something about preparing, alopecia planting, sunlight, soil potting, sunlight and water need. If I'm not happy with this, I can always go ahead and press Generate Another Outline, and this will give me different original ideas for this topic as well. So once this is done, I can see that perhaps I want to move this over to here and make it a little bit tailored. Maybe I find that some of this is a little bit repetitive, so I can always delete a heading point as well. A common section that I might want to add is on FAQs. So I can say comment, questions on managing and alopecia. So now that I have quite a thorough outline, I can go ahead and add some talking points that I want to be covered in the topic itself. This is completely optional. You don't have to unless there's something specific that you want to say. But for instance, if I want to type something here and say that alopecia love loose soil, the AI will take this talking point and weave it directly into the article itself. If there are certain topics that you don't know much about and you feel like could be benefited from some research, you can use our content detective tool to look for some talking point. So if I go ahead and click this, what Content Detective does is to start looking for information related to how to place an alocasia indoors. And you can see it's come up with some talking points for us on how to place alocasias in areas of high humidity, watering, and avoiding cold drafts and temperature changes. If I find any of these points not useful for me, I can also just go ahead and delete them. And if I want to, similarly to my other talking point, I can also add something here that I want to talk about specifically. What Content Detective is really useful for is for things like breaking news or for detailed and niche topics that you don't know much about. And maybe you just want to verify, learn a little bit more about this topic and give the AI some additional talking points that are in real time from the internet. You can see here that Content Detective has also provided the sources where these talking points came from. So this is where it's really useful to take your links and, you know, link out from your article directly itself. Once I think my outline is in pretty good shape, I'm going to go ahead and generate the article itself. And here you can see that I have my full outline as well as this generate article button right here. Just going to go ahead and click it. So now you can see that you have an article here that gives you a really good first draft to start building on. You can see here that it comes out to 2,000 words on the dot. Now that your first draft has been written, it's time to go in and refine it. So I'll start by finding a section where I want to go into a bit more detail. For instance, this section here on preparing your alocasia for planting. Maybe I want to add on a few more tips on how to actually prepare my alocasia. In this case, I can use the compose feature. What composes is a really smart autocomplete. It can help you continue your sentences or even forward your instructions to continue writing more. So in this case, I'm going to click this compose button, but you can also use the shortcut Command Enter to start composing. Great, you can see here that Compose has added even more tips for me on how to continue planting my application. So if I like this, I can go ahead and accept, or if I don't, I can just press discard. Great, so maybe I want to make all of these into individual points. And maybe I don't actually want summary, so go ahead and just delete that right there. So while that's one way you can use Compose, you can also add some instruction. For instance, if I would like here. For instance, if here I would like this in a list instead, I can always type instruction, write a list of 5 steps to determine the best place to place my alocasia. Let's go ahead and enter. Compose. And then you have it. You can see a list of steps that got generated just based on these instructions that I gave for Compose. So as you can see, you can expand and give a lot more detail to your content and just make it really authoritative as well as thorough. To add even more context to your article, you can also use the More Customization section right here. So here you can choose your point of view, whether it's from the first person, the I or we perspective, which is a little bit more intimate. You can also use the second person perspective, which is you, which is a little bit more casual and you can relate to your audience a bit better. Or if you want to be professional and formal, you can use the third person, which will write the article from a they perspective. Here you can also describe your audience, your brand, or your product or service. One thing that's useful for is if you have a certain call to action. For instance, if you want your audience to be looking at purchasing the right soil or to purchase some grow lights, for instance, you can see plant enthusiasts that are interested in grow lights, for instance. And this is where the AI will take this into account and weave some things around grow lights into your article. Similarly, if you have a specific product or a specific service that you want to promote, you can describe them briefly here, whether it's in bullet points or just a short one-liner. And the AI will actually take that and weave that into some promotional paragraphs in the article itself.